Hi guys, today I'm going to talk to you about how I booked 50 weddings in my first year of business. Now that I've shot all those weddings, I can tell you that it's a really bad idea to do that. But it really did help my business a ton, even though it exhausted me for the next year where I was shooting all of them. I know that there's a ton that goes into booking weddings, and that like your website and your style and your branding and your how do you respond to emails and all that kind of stuff. And we're gonna go over that, all of that in other videos, but today I'm just gonna talk to you about where I found each of these clients, how they booked me, what I chose to invest my money in so that I could get more clients, all that kind of stuff to hopefully help you build a sustainable business too, because I know when you're starting out, getting bookings might be like one of the most stressful parts of photography. Like, you could be the best photographer in the world but still not get bookings and have no idea why. So I'm just gonna talk to you about how I positioned myself to find leads and how I booked those 50 weddings, where they came from, all that kind of stuff. So thanks for watching. Okay, to start on the very first of my photography journey, I went to a workshop in Hawaii. It was awesome. And that was where I did my first styled shoot. That styled shoot ended up helping me out in more ways than I ever knew then. I just thought it was like giving me some kind of content and building my confidence, but it ended up helping me book so many weddings. I think at the beginning of your business, getting content in any way you can is the most important thing to be doing. So I went to that workshop, and then I also photographed like any friend that would let me, any couple that would let me. I messaged random people on Instagram and asked them if they wanted a free shoot. I just pretty much went after it and did a million different free shoots to try and build up my portfolio. If you haven't done that, just go after it. Try and photograph anyone that will let you, pretty much. Another great way to get content is going to a styled shoot. I know a ton of photographers here in Boston put them on, but if they don't put them on somewhere in your area, it's really not that hard to put on yourself. You just need like a model, a dress, flowers. Like, people really want to be a part of that because they like getting the photos, so it's not super hard to put on yourself, and I definitely recommend that for getting content. So my first wedding I got in kind of an unconventional way. I actually saw the posting for it on a Facebook group. Somebody asked if anyone would be willing to shoot their wedding for free, and I jumped on that. I know to shoot a wedding, you kind of need to have a wedding first. It's kind of like what came first, the chicken or the egg, because you can't really like get either without the other. So when I saw this Facebook posting for a wedding that you could shoot for free, I was all over it. I was like, oh my god, are you kidding me? That's amazing. I'm gonna get so much experience, which is kind of funny now looking back on it. But it really helped. I shot that wedding. It was fine. I got portfolio experience, so I had a whole wedding to show for, which was awesome. I know that random postings don't happen often, so now I would recommend second shooting to get your portfolio experience. I've actually never second shot in my life, which I kind of regret now, because I'm going to weddings and I'm like, I know I do it this way, but I wonder how other people do it. Like, am I doing things right? I don't know, hopefully, because I'm sharing it with all of you. So if I'm wrong, then we're all screwed. But yeah, second shooting is a great way to build up your portfolio too, while learning under a lead photographer, which is literally invaluable. Like, getting that experience under someone is so helpful. So if you can do that, then absolutely try. Also with second shooting, as a lead photographer, so many people message me about second shooting. It's crazy. Literally like a message a day is coming from this photographer that I don't know, that I've never talked to, that has never interacted with me, offering to second shoot. And while that's great, there's like a million other people coming to me to offer to second shoot, and the only people I'm going with ever are the ones that I already have a relationship with, that I know work hard, that I know will be enjoyable at the wedding, that I know has good experience. So just coming to me and like sliding into my DMs and being like, hey, I second shoot if you ever need one, like, that's nice, but I just don't, like, you're not putting enough effort. If you've ever done that, then you need to try a little bit harder. I'm sorry to tell you, but coming from a lead photographer, I get so many of those, and like, it doesn't work. So also, if you're doing even less than that and you're just putting on your Instagram stories that you'll be happy to second shoot, that is doing like even less than the bare minimum. So if you're not getting like leads from photographers from that, I'm not super surprised, because you have literally put in no effort. So I'm so sorry if that was harsh, but I mean, it's just honest. Like, you know. Also, when you second shoot, make sure your lead photographer is okay with you using those photos as portfolio work, because some photographers are not, and you don't want to do all this work and then not be able to have anything to show for it. So just make sure you like get set up with your photographer well. Okay, so after I did that free Facebook wedding and I went to that workshop in Hawaii, I put myself on Thumbtack, which a lot of people haven't heard of Thumbtack, and I honestly don't even know how I found it, but it pretty much is just a website where people can like post what they need, and then other people who like do that job can like fulfill that need pretty much. So like somebody will post like, I need a wedding photographer for this date, I have this many guests and this is my budget, and then like a whole bunch of photographers will message them and they'll pick which one they want. So it's kind of like the opposite of the not, where like you're posting your service and people are finding you, like these people are posting what they need and the services are finding them, if that makes any sense. So pretty much that means that the person who comes in and says they'll do it for the cheapest is someone that succeeds, in my experience. But I did book my first 4 real weddings on Thumbtack, so it helped me build a portfolio. Some of them were actually great and like super nice people, and other ones were not as great, but still built my portfolio. But I still do recommend Thumbtack for getting your first like couple weddings on your own. It was really helpful for me. Yes, I only booked them for like $300 to $600, which is not a ton of money. But when I was first starting out, I was like, oh my God, I'm rich. So yeah, and just having someone pay for your work like felt really good at that point. But yeah, Thumbtack was great for me. I think it's a great way to get your first few weddings if that's what you're looking for, just doing something for cheap, build up that portfolio. Also on this note, I think a lot of like photographers like to sell you on this idea that if you just like charge what you're worth and like show how great you are, then it's gonna be rainbows and butterflies and you're gonna get all these bookings. But in my experience, like it's a little bit more complicated than that. Like it's great if you're charging what you're worth, but if you're charging $4,000 and you've never shot a wedding before, you don't have anything to show for it, then no one's gonna hire you likely. I think that you need to like grind it out a little bit, put in the work, like do what you can, maybe take on weddings that aren't with your ideal client so you can later elevate yourself and get weddings that are with your ideal client. You know what I mean? Like as great as it sounds that if you're just like confident in yourself and you're doing great work and you believe in yourself, then everything will come together. I don't think that's always true. I think that's part of it, but I think that you do need to hustle a little bit, especially in the beginning, build up your portfolio, and then later you can be picky. The dreaded knot. I feel so nervous talking about the knot because I know so many people have had bad experiences and also feel like very passionately about those bad experiences. Like I'm a part of Facebook groups and people just shit on the knot all the time and be like, you can't waste money doing that, like do this instead. And I was on the knot for a year. And honestly, it was probably the best thing I've ever done with my business. Within the first 2 months, I was fully booked for the whole next year. The only reason I'm able to make this video, how I booked 50 weddings in my first year of business, is because of the knot. I paid $280 a month, which was a lot at the time for me because, again, I was making like $300 a wedding, so it was a lot. But I charged $1,500 for people who found me on the knot, so I knew that I only had to book like 2 weddings and it would pay for the whole year's worth of advertising. And I booked 30 weddings on the knot, so it obviously paid back. And I think I got around like 10 inquiries a day, which is a lot of freaking inquiries. And yes, a lot of them were like, what are your pricings, and like pretty basic and like not exactly what you want to have in your inbox. But I think sometimes people are a little bit too harsh on clients that are inquiring. Like they don't know what they're supposed to ask. They don't, like, I mean, money matters. Like yes, they'd probably love to be able to afford a $10,000 photographer and not care about what you cost, but that's just not the reality of some people's lives. So like it didn't really bother me just being asked like how much I charge. I would just like tell them. Once I increased my pricing to the second tier, I knew I wasn't gonna get that much inquiries because I was right in the middle with like literally everyone else. But once I increased my pricing again, I became on the top tier and there's literally no one on there. There's no one listed on there. And I still get inquiries from the knot even though I'm doing like a free plan. There's more room at the top. That is what I've learned from being on the knot. So I'm not paying anything, but I'm still getting leads from them. So again, I know that people feel very passionately about this, but I found a lot of success on the knot because I was cheap. I think is the only reason. So I don't really recommend it if you're in that like middle tier because I really don't think you'll get that many inquiries, but it really did help me build my portfolio. People also always ask me if I found like my ideal client on the knot. And first of all, I think ideal client has become kind of this like skewed idea. Like my ideal client is really just someone who values me. Like I don't need to have every single thing in common with them for them to be my ideal client. Like if they value me and my work, then they are awesome in my mind. And I think all that needs to happen so that they do value me is that I also value them and I value our relationship, and I'll show them that I'll work on their behalf. Maybe some people like don't have that as their ideal client, but pretty much everyone from the knot became my ideal client because I was invested in our relationship enough that they valued me. And also I did find a lot of really cool people on the knot. Like the second inquiry I ever got, it was a wedding I actually shot last October. They got married at this mountain in Massachusetts. It was awesome. And then we got to go up like the chairlift and go to the top of the mountain, and it was the most like beautiful thing ever. And I found them on the Knot, and they were this like crazy adventurous super cool couple, and I found so many other people like them too. Like those 30 weddings I booked on the Knot, like those people were awesome, honestly. So yes, I found my ideal client, and also I made people my ideal client who like wouldn't have been originally, whatever that means. Okay, so once I had that big portfolio from The Knot, I started getting referrals from other photographers. I think my work improved a ton, so I was getting like respect from other photographers pretty much, and then a ton of my leads were coming in from them. Again, like, I got 10 leads a day from The Knot. I only booked 30 of those weddings, so however many hundreds of leads I was getting from there that I couldn't shoot myself, I was sending those to other photographers. They were sending me them in return. And so eventually I was getting a ton of leads from other photographers, because who knows people who are getting married and looking for photographers better than other photographers who have already gotten those leads and are already booked. Like, being competitive with photographers in your area literally makes no sense. Like, they're the people who can help you out the most. I just think it's so stupid. Anyways, so I do get a lot of my business from referrals, and a lot of my business from referrals from past clients. Like, I think, again, showing that I'm genuine and wanting a good relationship with them and wanting to do good work for them helps me out so much, because they refer their friends. Right now, I book about 50% from referrals and 50% from Instagram now. I think it's because I have shot those 50 weddings, so I have a ton of stuff I can share on Instagram. Like, my portfolio is built up, and I've done a good enough job that I still get referrals from those past clients and from other photographers. So that's what I'm currently doing to get business. This video like wasn't as funny, and I'm sorry I wasn't like goofy as much. I really just wanted to sit down and talk with you guys about this, because I think that so many people struggle with it, and so many people have this like skewed idea of where their couples are and stuff like that. Like, why am I not getting couples on Instagram? Like, it's algorithm. The algorithm's out to get me and all this stuff. And I'm like, makes no sense. Like, go somewhere else. I think to find your couples, you need to look up whatever niche you are in, whatever area you are, see what comes up on Google, and then put yourself there. For me, when I looked up wedding photographers in Boston, The Knot came up, and I was like, oh, this is where people are looking for their photographers, so I need to be there. I hope that makes sense, and I hope this isn't coming off too harsh, but I just really want to like grind it home that A, you need to hustle for it, and B, you need to stop caring about Instagram, and C, you need to put yourself where other people are actually looking for photographers so they can find you. In those first 50 weddings, like, even though I wasn't charging a ton, even though some of them weren't like my ideal location or ideal client or whatever the heck you want to say, they helped me out so much in my business. Now I have raised my prices a ton since then. I say no to people all the time just because they're not like vibing with me. Like, I'm in such a better position now that I have just grinded it out for that first year. Again, I am very tired from shooting 50 weddings in 1 year. That was a lot to take on, and I don't recommend that for anyone. Maybe stick to like a good 30, like a good 25. Like, don't go for all 50. But it did help me out so much. And now I don't pay anything for advertising. Like, if it's all coming from referrals and it's all coming from Instagram, I pay $0 in advertising, which is awesome. That is such a big cost that I don't have to pay for anymore. Another piece of advice, if you're not gonna invest in yourself, no one else will. If you're not willing to shell out the money to go on The Knot, then who's gonna invest their money into you? You know? Like, if you don't believe in yourself enough, then why do you expect anyone else to believe in you? If you're doing all of these things and you've positioned yourself really well to be where clients are looking for photographers and you're still not getting other bookings, I would definitely recommend looking at other aspects of your business, like maybe your website, maybe your brand, maybe even your photos. Like, really try to correct everything and get at it at a holistic approach. This isn't a one-stop shop. Like, if you go on The Knot and you're charging like $4,000 and your pictures aren't very good and your brand is really boring, then yeah, you're probably not gonna get any inquiries. You need to have like other things going for you in order for this to work. The whole point of this whole like YouTube video things is helping you guys book more clients, and I'm going to try and show you like all the other things I do with my business that help me do that, but this is like exactly how I actually did that. So I hope this was helpful for you guys. I know it was like a lot of information thrown out, and pretty much I just told you to like work hard, but that's truly how I feel. Position yourself to be in front of clients, and I think that you will succeed. If anyone has any questions, like always, like message me. I'll try to help you out. But yeah, I hope this was helpful. I hope you guys have a great day. I hope you get a freaking ton of inquiries in the future. Keep killing it.